Zarys Weaker sat in his backyard looking at his homework. It was a long list of words he was supposed to put into alphabetical order.
"The alphabet bores me,"
said Zack. He didn't like ordinary homework. He liked to read books full of strange facts or prowl through a dictionary looking for unusual words, especially words beginning with Z. Zack leaned back, closed his eyes and thought about his name and initial ZZ.
"What wonderful initials to have. ZZ, ZZ, Z."
Zack found himself drifting into space. He seemed to be rocking jerkily and then realized that he was being carried into a cage by four hooded figures. The road twisted back and forth and he was jolted from side to side against the bars. He suddenly saw a tall man in a guard uniform galloping up on an odd-looking animal. He glared down at Zack.
"Zounds, you must be the boy our secret police recused from the terrible place whose name begins with an A."
Zack supposed he meant America but was too frightened to ask.
"I am Zsigmond the Seventh. What is your name?"
"Zarys Weaker,"
stammered Zack.
"Zarys Weaker, four Zs,"
said Zsigmond,
misunderstanding Zack's pronunciation.
"With a name like that, you should go far here."
He put him down and stepped out.
"The road twisted so much that I became dizzy,"
said Zack as he staggered out.
"All our roads are zigzag roads. Welcome to this land, the land of Zetabit. You haven't learned your ZYX yet. Right now, you say the Zetabit backwards, but soon you will recite it properly as fast as I do."
Zsigmond jumped off his seat and said,
"You will notice I am riding on our national animal, the zebra."
Zack knew enough about animals to know that zebra can never be tamed. Zsigmond's zebra looked like a horse with black strips painted on it.
"Are you sure? Is it a zebra, sir?"
asked Zack.
"I think you got cheated."
"Silence. When I say it is a zebra, it is a zebra."
"Yes, sir,"
said Zack.
"But it still looked like a horse with a bad paint job."
"Be careful, young Zweaker. You may be asked some questions and if you answer them correctly, you may become a number one Zislander. But if you answer them incorrectly, you will be turned into a terrible creature. Now listen closely to our rules."
"Yes, sir."
"You can use ordinary words that begins with the unimportant last letter of Zetabel. LKJIHGFEDCB and even A. But important names must begin with important letters. Above all, no A names are tolerated here. They are forbidden. Do you understand?"
"Yes, sir."
"Then go. From now, you will travel this road alone. I shall fly on ahead and be waiting to meet you at my place, the famous Zenith Ziggurat."
Zigging left, zagging right, up the road went nervous Zarys Weaker. Even if he answered all the questions right, what was the impossible thing he would have to do to get away from this land and to go home? The first place he came along the road was a shop with flowers and a sign that said PHLOWER Flower SHOP.
What a silly way to spell flower,
he thought. But then he remembered that F was at the wrong end of the zitterbend. A man came out of the shop, held his hand and said,
Before you pass my shop, you must tell me the name of our national flower.
Zack almost laughed. This was easy for someone who knew a lot of Z words.
I know, the zinnia.
Pass.
Zack zigzagged on ahead till he came to a shop with a sign that said YEWELERY, Yevelery SHOP shop. Even before a woman came out of the shop, Zack knew the answer.
Your national Yevel.
Zircon.
Pass. But then next came a shop with globes in it. The sign in the shop was YEOGRAPHY, Geography SHOP shop. He felt more nervous than ever. Geography was not one of his best subjects. A huge man came running out.
Stop! I am Zog, the geographer, and I have 3 questions for you. What are the 3 African nations we like best?
Zack brightened up.
Zaire, Zambia and Zimbabwe.
Right. Second question. What is the name of Zambia's great river?
The Zambezi.
Splendid. You couldn't have done better if you were a Zulu. You must have got Z grades in geography in school. But now be careful. What are the 2 greatest rivers in the world?
Zack was scared, but he remembered the rules.
There is the Mississippi and the Amazon. Pass.
At that moment, they heard the rumble of a motor overhead. Zog pointed.
There goes Zsigmond the 7th.
Zooming back to the Zenith cigarette in his Zeppelin. As he zigzagged along, Zack realized how hungry he was. When suddenly he saw a coin lying on the ground.
It must be the polished coin called a zloty, and it is sure to be made of zinc. Now all I need to buy is a snack.
By this time he had reached the gates of Zenith Cigarette, set in a huge wall. In front of the wall was a shop with the sign Ziggy's Snack Stand. There he met Ziggy, who said,
Stop, you have to buy and eat our national food. Do you have some money?
Yes, sir, I have a zloty.
Splendid. In that case, you can have our national food.
Zack saw a bowl full of what looked like boiled green pumpkin. Then he remembered what it was.
This is Jushchuni. Smart boy. Now you will eat Jushchuni with zest and zeal.
Zack was so furious, he banged the counter and said,
I came all this way and answered all the silly questions. And now I am starving to death and I want a burger.
A thunderous sound made Zack drill around. The great gates of Zenith Cigarette were swinging open. Zsigmond the 7th came rushing out with a squad of mean-looking soldiers.
Zari Zwicker, eat your Jushchuni,
roared Zsigmond.
I hate Jushchuni. I hate this land. I want to go back to America.
Now you have done something unforgivable. You have used an A word in front of me.
I don't care. I want to go back to Yuban.
Another A word? Take him away, or better yet, put him in a cage or take him to a zoo.
No, I answered all your questions, so I shall be allowed to go home.
Silence. There is a way out. You can ask me a question about Zitabet. That I can't answer, then I can let you go home.
I have got it. Can you recite the Zitabet?
Of course, that is easy.
Backwards.
Backwards?
Now, Zisman turned pale and stuttered.
Well, of course, I can.
He cleared his throat.
A, B, C, D, F. No, that's not right. A, B, C, D, G.
Wrong again. I am going.
No, wait.
Shouted Zizmund.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, M, L, O, dot.
Zack's eyes popped open. Much to his surprise, he was back home in his own backyard and glad to be there in Appletown Avenue in Yuban, Alabama in America. That's it for today, students. I hope you enjoyed this video. You can subscribe my channel to learn more stories from Suman's Academy. I'm gonna go get some more.